Good morning, friends. This morning I'm here in the Purple Door, our godly playroom. I wanted to gather here in this space, even though we can't be here all together, I wanted to have our time of children's worship together. And I'm so glad that you are here with me. To start this morning, let's sing one of our songs together that we sing a lot in children's worship. Let's sing, In My Life. You ready? So, In My Life, Lord, be glorified, be glorified. In my life, Lord, be glorified today. And then we'll say, In our church. Let's do that one together. In my life, Lord, be glorified, be glorified. In my life, Lord, be glorified today. In our church, Lord, be glorified, be glorified. In our church, Lord, be glorified today. Let's also sing this morning, In Our Home. Let's hold our hands like we're holding hands with our moms and dads and brothers and sisters.
In my home, Lord, be glorified, be glorified. In my home, Lord, be glorified today.
Okay, before we hear today's story, let's prepare. Maybe you want to sit crisscross applesauce, put your hands in your laps. Let's close our eyes and let's just take a few moments to take a deep breath. And as you sit, listen to what sounds you might hear around you. Maybe it's a fan going or someone talking. See if you can hear your own heart beating. And when you're ready, you may open your eyes. Okay. This morning's story is about baptism, holy baptism. We baptize people in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. The Creator, the Redeemer, the Sustainer. This water is the same water from creation, the same dangerous waters of the flood, the waters the people walked through into freedom, the waters that Jesus was baptized in, the waters that you were or will be baptized in. There was once a man
who told such wonderful and amazing things that people began to follow him. But the people did not know who he was. One day, someone asked the man who he was, and he said, "I am the light." The Holy Spirit goes where it will. It rides the invisible wave, an invisible wind, like the dove. And it comes to us when we need comfort and peace and strength. The Holy Spirit is invisible, like this scent. Can't see it, but we know it's there. People get baptized as babies and as children, as teenagers and as adults. We will use a baby today to see what happens in baptism. We say and ask questions to the person being baptized, and they make promises. But if they're too little to answer the questions like the baby, then the questions are asked to the parents and godparents. We also say some prayers for them. Then we are ready for baptism. But wait, this child needs a name. Sarah. Names are very important in baptism. Sarah, I baptize you in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You are sealed by the Holy Spirit and claimed as one of Christ's own. Sarah, remember the day of your baptism. Holly, remember the day of your baptism. And this candle is for you. Remember the day of your baptism. Look, the light is getting bigger. And the light that all light comes from is not getting smaller. The light fills the space. See what happens if I change my light. No, I did not say put it out or extinguish it. I I said change. See what happens as I change the light. The light begins to fill the space. The light is everywhere, and everywhere I go, my light is with me. Wherever Sarah goes, her light is with her too. And you, watch what happens to your light. Your light too fills this space. And wherever you go, your light is there with you. And one day, there came a time that the light had to change. It could no longer be in one place, but wanted to be everywhere. So watch as the Christ candle changes and fills the space. I wonder what your work will be today. I know you don't have the story at home, but I hope you'll take a few minutes with me and spend some time working. In just a minute, you'll see as I work, and you can see what I create today. And then we'll come back and we'll finish our time together. Only you know what's right, what you want to work with today. But let's spend a moment now together working.
Thank you.
Now is the time that we would normally come back together and we would share our work if we wanted to. When I sat down to work today, I kind of drew what came to mind. I drew the picture of my light and my candle to remember the day that I was baptized. And I also had a picture of my head and the waters of baptism sprinkling down like I sprinkled when I was holding the water. I drew a heart because it made me feel very happy. I don't know what your work was, but if you would like to share it, have your mom and dad take a picture of it and send it to me. I would love to see your work and what you did during this time. Before we close today, let's say a prayer and we'll sing our goodbye song together. Five here, five there. Put them together and let's say a prayer. Dear God, thank you for today. Thank you for our baptism and for the light we received from you. Thank you for loving us. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, let's sing our goodbye song. Go now in peace. Go now in peace. May the love of God surround you everywhere, everywhere you may go. I hope I see you next time, friends. See you next week.